How should we explain to our non-Muslim friends that we Muslims don't believe in the celebration of birthdays and anniversaries?
Let's ask the question that how can we explain to a non-Muslim that we Muslims don't believe in the celebration of birthdays and anniversaries? Sister, I am aware that there are a group of Muslims who say that celebrating birthday is haram. As far as I am concerned, I don't know of any Quranic verse which says celebrating birthday is haram, or any Sahih Hadith which says celebrating birthday or making anniversary is haram. So I per se do not say that celebrating birthday is haram, but most of the birthday celebrated becomes haram for other reasons, for many reasons. For example, television per se is not haram. Fine. Cable TV per se is not haram, but because more than 95% or 99% what comes on the satellite channel, cable TV is haram, therefore we say that it is better to avoid it.
So watching
television per se is not haram. But if you are very restrictive and see to it that you utilize the right way, it can be halal. But as far as the general rule is concerned, most of the birthdays as a festival which is made is haram. For example, birthday of whether it be Buddha, birthday of Shri Krishna, because this leads to idol worship. So celebrating birthdays, whether it be of their so-called gods or whether it be of messenger, the reason you tell them that we have to worship only Almighty God. And does God have a birthday? If God has a birthday, that means God has origin, he was created. That itself is sufficient. So if you are celebrating a birthday to revere that particular person, it leads to idol worship. The only one that you should worship in this world is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that is the reason we say that making birthdays of personalities to commemorate them indirectly or directly leads to idol worship. It may be directly like celebrating the birthday of Jesus Christ, peace be upon him. We love Jesus Christ, peace be upon him. We respect him. But the moment you start celebrating, you start making a god out of him. It leads to idol worship, hero worship, which leads to shirk, which is the biggest sin in Islam. That is the reason celebrating birthdays of any personality to commemorate becomes haram. Clear cut. So if you ask me, celebrating birthday of any prophet or any personality to commemorate is haram, which I agree. Because there's a thumb rule in Islam. According to Ibn Taymiyyah, he has derived from the Sahih Hadith, that in things dealing with worship, ibadah, what is mentioned in the Quran and Sahih Hadith should be followed. What is not mentioned is haram. What is mentioned is halal. For example, how to offer salah. It is mentioned that Dura Fatain, read Surah Fatiha, and then you say, okay, I will read something else. I will not read Surah Fatiha. I will narrate a hadith in my salah. Then I say, but why read hadith? No, but no hadith says that you should not narrate hadith. So in terms of worship, what is mentioned is halal or fard, depending upon the category. But what is not mentioned is haram. Tomorrow you cannot say, I want to offer salah by standing on one leg. Fine. But if I say, you can't offer salah on one leg. You say, why? Show me a hadith which says that you cannot stand on one leg. Show me a Quranic verse which says you cannot stand on one leg. See, what is mentioned is allowed as far as worship ibadah is concerned. But in mamlaat, in the other aspects besides worship, worship includes salah, ibadah, you know, zakat, everything. In terms of business and the other worldly things not relating directly to worship, what is mentioned as haram is haram. What is not mentioned is halal. Fine. What is mentioned as haram in the Quran and the Sahih Hadith is haram. What is not mentioned may either be in the makruh category, mubah category, mustahab or fard, all coming into the halal category. For example, Quran says having pork is haram, having alcohol is haram. The foods which are mentioned as haram in the Quran and Sahih Hadith are haram. Anything else is halal. Simple. Mango is not mentioned in the Quran that you can eat mango. Is it mentioned? No. Is it mentioned in the Sahih Hadith? Or it's not mentioned, that means haram? No. It's not mentioned means mubah, optional. Halal. In the halal, it may either be mubah, mubah means optional. It can be mustab, means encourage. It can be fard. If it's not mentioned as fard, so it can't be fard. You should realize the two types of guidance in the Sharia. One is on ibadah, which if it's mentioned, it is allowed, halal. If not mentioned, it is haram. In the other aspects of worldly affairs, of mamlaat, about non-worship activities, what is mentioned as haram is haram. Everything else is halal. So as far as celebrating birthday of a personality, it comes in the category of worship. So because it is not mentioned in the Quran, the Sahih Hadith, that you cannot celebrate birthdays, it's not mentioned, so it becomes haram. It leads to shirk. Is it clear? But celebrating birthday of an individual person as a worldly affair, there are some Muslims who say it's haram, which I don't agree, because that comes in worldly affairs. But in our school, we have mentioned that children should not, it leads to haram. They may be dancing, they may be music, it leads to haram. But as a general fatwa, you cannot say celebrating birthday of your son or your daughter is haram, but you can say it is makruh, or best is to avoid. If you don't do it, it's the best. So why? Because on your birthday, you may have music, you may have various other things. Because there's no hadith we say, do not celebrate the birthday of your son. Now, celebrating the birthday of your son does not come in the worship, ibadah aspect. Is it clear? But yet, in our school, for example, wearing cap is not fard. But in our IRF, every staff should wear a cap. Mustahab. So it is fard according to IRF rules. So therefore, celebrating birthday is haram according to IIS rule. Everything haram in IIS rule may not be haram in the Sharia. And everything fard in IIS rules, Islam International School rules, may not be fard in Islam. For example, our children, they have to wear a particular dress, the same color, grayish blue or bluish gray. It is fard according to IIS rules. But outside, it's not fard in Islam. So you should realize, but we cannot make a haram thing fard. We can make a mustahab thing fard. We can make a mubah thing which is fard. We can make a fard fard. So very clear cut. And there was a non-Muslim who was a revert. And she came to me one day, along with my wife. And she was narrating that how she accepted Islam, mashallah. And how she brought up her children. And when she goes to a mother's place, and a sister who loves her very much, one day she had a birthday. And she was aware that my sister does not like celebrating birthdays. So purposely she didn't get the birthday cake. On that day, next day she bought a birthday cake, but which was mentioned happy birthday. And she said, I won't have. And she gave the option to her children that if you want, you can have. And only thing she whispered that it is haram to have cake. And I told her that it's not haram, and she was shocked. See, seeing this situation, she's a non-Muslim. She wants to present the right picture to a sister who's a Hindu. At this point, I told her it would have been preferable that she would have had the cake. But unfortunately, she thought it was haram, therefore she didn't have, so she'll get a sawab. But actually, it's not haram to have a cake of her sister. So normally, I will tell the Muslims, you avoid, if your sister is a Muslim and she gives birth the cake, you don't have, no problem. It's not haram to have. It is mustahab not to have because they're not encouraging her, correct? So the same thing is there. So if your sister who's a Muslim gets a birthday cake for you, you don't have it. It's good, it's mustahab. But here it's a revert who goes to a non-Muslim sister. And now having a cake is such a small issue. The bigger issue is shirk. So a more important thing that you should correct is the shirk rather than having cake or not. If you have got the cake of Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, or Shri Krishna, that time if she didn't have, it's fine. So we as Dais, we as Muslims should realize the boundaries of the Sharia. So this is my view. Many people may disagree. It's my view that celebrating birthday of an individual person at home is not haram, but I would say we can say makruh. Muslims should not celebrate, I'm telling that. Fine. If I tell you, don't drink water while standing. But drinking water while standing is not haram, it is makruh. Sister, when you're speaking with non-Muslim, don't get these issues of celebrating birthdays. It's a minor issue. Yes, celebrating birthdays of prophets, of great personality, that you can give a logical reason, which I gave in the earlier part of my answer. But celebrating birthday of other individual, that's a small issue. Yes, you can say that in your birthday there's music, there's dancing, people wear obscene clothes, that you can pick up. But don't pick up on things which are very small. As a Muslim running da'wah to non-Muslim, try and educate her on things which are major. Or things which are minor but are logically very well established and will be helpful for you to get them to the main issues, like not to have alcohol. So these are minor issues which people attack Islam. A man is allowed to marry more than one wife. That's not the major issue, but That is the issue which brings an obstacle in the mind of the non-Muslim. So clarify that cobweb. Is it clear? So in this way, if you do dawah, inshallah, it will be successful. Hope that answers the question. Any brother have any questions?
Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam.
Brother, sometimes people say us namaste, they greet.